Doing?
So here's our, do that.
The first shot of our trip.
I got a stretch pickup on the way back, so.
That's what we all.
Oh, we got a limo instead. And we're on our way to.
We're going to Africa.
Very cool. See you soon.
Well, talk about spoiled. Look at Dorney there, huh? On the cell phone, pulling pulling everybody we can. Tell them that we got picked up on our way to Africa. Anyway, we'll see you at the airport, I guess. Okay.
Yeah, and it was sad.
That's where I was taking the picture.
Leaving Jonathan and like I said, I just.
Well, okay, what a way to get a ride to the airport, huh?
Well, here we are in the limo going to London, then we'll be going to Africa. Yeah, we're excited. Got a limo that picked us up. Didn't expect it. But hey, here it is.
Yeah.
I'm going towards
Roberto's.
I got no rings on because, you know, we don't have rings there because they don't know the difference from cheap to expensive.
I did though.
Yeah. Dawn brought those because she's spoiled.
No, not my wedding band.
Anyway, we're gonna see you at the airport.
Wait. So
and we'll see you in London. Take care.
We're on our way to San Francisco.
Camera, maybe.
Recording.
Right, so you're on video?
I need to
Hello,
zoom.
Hello, how you doing?
How
Let's
do you take the
light.
Zoom up? What are you
All
doing,
right. Man? Take two. We're having pasta.
I am, anyway.
Going out of the south. We're at the San Francisco airport. And not bad.
Not bad. That's called the fire or something. So, when are we going to leave?
Okay. So we're going to leave, it's 10 to 5, we're going to leave at about 5:20, we're going to get over there. At 6:25, we get in the plane, go to London. How about going to London? Oh yeah, fish and chips and all that shit.
Okay.
We're going to have fun.
Pull your pill out. Time for the pill.
Oh yeah, we got pill. We're going to take one of these each for malaria. It'll be fun, something to do. We'll see you there. I'll see you in the plane.
Two.
Hi, we're at San Francisco Airport.
What are you doing now?
This is the Virgin.
That's our plane.
Yep.
That's the one we're getting on.
One of our planes.
Ah.
And then that's a view of all San Francisco hills.
Oh yeah, we're getting on the sky there. We're on our way, man.
Yep.
The life jacket is untouchable behind your seat. In case of landing on water, after removing your helmet cover, slip the jacket over your head. Fasten straps around your waist and tie them securely in a double knot at the start of order, firmly on the red tag.
I knew that.
Not to be invasive by blowing into the tube.
Oh, there's Air France. We're not going to France, we're going to freaking Africa. First London.
Here we are.
London first.
We're in first class, having champagne.
What do you got there? Mambo juice?
Yeah.
Mambo juice.
A little champagne with some orange juice.
Champagne.
And we're getting the directions.
Oh yeah, we got a little shit.
Yeah.
I guess we understood what they were saying.
Yeah.
We're ready to go. We're gonna go. To see you in London.
Yeah.
Bye. Well, here we are. At Heathrow Central. Gonna go down to London, Hadani. Where are we?
We're still in London.
Yeah, we're just getting ready to
our
go.
Our flight has been delayed, and we did meet up with the gates, so here we are.
Oh, there they are. They made it. Look at, they're all safaried out.
It's 9 o'clock.
Yeah, they're ready. Got his shoes and everything.
Yeah.
You ready to play some buffalo?
He's ready to ride the elephant.
The pills, the malaria pills.
And there's our plane standing by to go to Kenya, another Virgin Atlantic flight. Huh?
When we leave. Yeah. We'll
sorry to interrupt. Where are we?
Hi.
Well. Okay.
Well, we're
it's
Nairobi.
Tuesday. It's Tuesday, and we're here.
Yeah, we were supposed to be here yesterday.
I don't
Did
know
you know that, Robert?
How you could travel and get here.
Yeah, okay. Things changed.
Our whole agenda is 2 days. It's kind of wacky.
Hey guys, this is Nairobi, Donny. Yeah, right. Two clients, a shell and enjoying your trip? So you enjoying yourself?
Yes, it's beautiful, beautiful. We're in central Kenya right now.
Yes.
Where they grow their fruit.
And all those stands on the side, what are those about?
Fruit and vegetables.
Fruit and vegetables.
Fruit and vegetables. Speaking about fruits.
We were hoping
this guy. Aloha, listen here.
It looks like Hawaii.
So, and then they have the jumbo. Yeah. It's hello.
Jumbo.
And then.
Hello.
Hello. See?
I want this.
Yes, I do. Those are the elephants. Yeah, this is a very
beautiful. Yeah, it's 8,000 feet.
Yeah.
Here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No problem.
Let me get a picture of that. Hold on, hold on.
What do you see?
Same as I don't.
Look at the
boat. I'm very little, but
it's really sad.
Well, I love it.
Mm-hmm.
Got some fire now.
Yes, it is.
Oh, okay. Oh, we look so tired. Oh, yeah, it's so warm.
Yeah.
And these are the restrooms for the place here. Well, here's the bedroom, and
we'll take it tonight, and then they can have the suite tomorrow night.
No. Look at the bathroom here. They got a bidet in here too.
Get out of here.
Yeah, like that. Bathroom?
Yes, let's see what the color of water it is. I want
the view out.
Oh my god, Robert Salt.
Back. And this is the living room, and there's guy on the floor.
Hi.
Charging batteries. Nice sitting area. Desk, two doors that open to outside. Seating. This one door open.
And there's the view. Patio here. And another sitting area right here. From the patio. Great view. This is day one, by the way. We're at Malu. Well, what are we doing?
Bubble bath.
Look at that.
Got bubbles.
Bubbles.
Salt. And shampoo.
Very cool.
Mint shampoo. My first bath.
Needed it, huh?
Since Sunday, and it's Tuesday.
Cool.
I mean, this is rough in it, you know?
My whole house. You have the drums and the.
I do, yeah.
Oh, we got something come over. For sure, I wish that to me it is.
Your cow. Have
you ever heard of that? I think I've bought everything. Yeah. No. We sat on our friend's patio. That's ours there. What do we got there? We got out a window. Is that a rhino or something? We're laying in bed. And you can see right out there. Walking away. Oh, this is day two. Get up in the morning, right outside the door here. All these lovely little cows. It's about 6:30 or so in the morning. Cows are getting up. Everybody's getting up and stretching. Oh yeah, it's morning duty time. So like Bill.
Oh, see the poop. Get the poop. You get the poop?
Cool. Oh yeah, that's the second poop shot I got.
That's the second poop shot. Okay, Robert, look at me. Let me get you in this shot.
And there's Maureen in the morning, day two.
Yeah, daytime Maureen. Good night's sleep. Yeah. Fabulous. Feel great.
Yeah.
Out here, not on the Serengeti.
It's one of the cottages.
See, Yeah, we have lunch up there.
Yeah.
So we have lunch out. Yeah.
We have lunch at a certain cliff overlooking.
Good morning, Boniface.
Good morning.
How are you this morning?
Very well.
Good. Ready for a good day?
Ready yes. for a good day.
All right. It's Mr. Frank. Good morning, Frank.
Good morning, Rob.
Yeah, we were up at 5 and... Yeah, we were up at 5 though.
Are we all ready?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because it's still like 30 minutes.
Yeah, we found out that... I read the survival kit this morning.
Yeah, of course, I just called...
Did you see, Chris, did you see monkey yesterday?
Yes.
Did you see?
Yes.
Did you read the survival guide?
Okay, okay.
Well, it said by the gate.
There he is. That's the man right there.
After your deodorant, you could.
What's it called?
Try some of this. Smell it.
Oh, it's wonderful.
If you didn't have a bath, would you?
No,
a little cold down this morning for a bath.
Yeah.
Morning. How are you?
Fine, thanks.
Did you see that's the owner's house? No.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, Dustin. How are you today?
Fine, and you?
Good. We're ready for a big day.
Yes.
You're a designated driver. Very good.
Here we're in Malu. Malu is 6,000 feet high. It's one of those exclusive properties we have. We've just had an excellent night here. We are all settling down for breakfast. Malu is really a neat place. You'd wake up and you have your own family cottages or private cottages, and you own your own. You have a nice walk back to the dining. It's just a nice, beautiful place to start your safari. So most of our safaris, we do 3 nights here. You might wonder why you do 3 nights and there are no wildlife. Really, if you come here, you'd just discover the secret of Malu. It's unique, it's beautiful, it's homely, rustic furniture in your rooms. It's just amazing. We've always had our guests having a great time here. So again, we're getting ready to go to Lake Nakuru National Park. Lake Nakuru is just an hour and a half from here. It's the home of the flamingos of this country, really. And we're just having breakfast and we'll be leaving in a few minutes. And we're all looking forward to seeing many flamingos and rhinos.
Are the sweeter ones.
There's Chris and his son Simon down the end. How you guys doing?
Well, thank you.
Enjoying yourselves?
Yes, thank you.
Great.
When I'm
hungry.
She's
used to getting the things.
Yeah, she really is. Thank you. The dogs, if they'd like some meat. Oh, see, he's the protein.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Atkins. They prefer, people do, yeah. Mm-hmm.
There's going to be a way of...
Bring it with you.
Yeah. Yeah, so it cuts the skin off the outside and the blade in the middle. So an oval shape. You can just push it down the top.
Good.
You know those are easy, just easy wear sort of.
You didn't pack a bagel cutter.
So I see the reason I didn't buy these.
Because they're too good.
Yeah.
You are, Romy.
Thank you.
like a man.
Yeah, that's the beef right there. Oh.
That's the National Youth Training College. At some point, Israel helped us establish that. Kenya has had a close relationship with Israel, and they put it as a mandatory thing that before you join the university after high school, you'd spend your 2 years here at Gilgil, so that you participate in the youth service. And then the government realized that when the students were going to the university, they were hardened and they could throw stones and riot. Then they stopped the program altogether. They said, we are building, we are having more people who can throw stones because they've been hardened, they've been given paramilitary training. So the government stopped that program altogether. But I think it was a very nice program.
But they didn't cause harm, they just contributed to cause harm. They didn't get out and do anything. Like, you say the military, the kids, after they were trained, they
were building roads.
But they stopped the program because they thought they were doing something.
Yeah, they thought they were training hooligans, because when they went to the university, they were all hardened. And when there was a student riot, they could challenge the policemen. Dr. Griffin, the founder of Starehe Boys, he died, but he used to be the one who set up the National Youth Training. Okay. It's not a freshwater lake. Lake Naivasha is freshwater here, but then sometimes the flamingos would be coming there, small pockets of flamingos. And you can see at the center this white things look like. Oops.
Point on the road.
Most of all, actually, all our safari vehicles are plain, nothing fancy.
On the road. There are monkeys walking down the road. We're at the national park. We'll keep that portion out of the video, the whole ride here. That'll deter people from going on any safari. Here's our friend Chris we met along the way. How you doing, Chris?
Oh boy.
Having a good time?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was a great ride.
Yeah.
I'm going over to this shop here.
Like a
I think they want to charge us for that.
Oh, that's fine. That looks okay.
Drop it at the other gate and move on. So, because we, as a company, we have a company card which loads all the money.
Can you zoom in?
They're all over almost like.
Massive.
Man, that sun is.
This is massive. This is one of the most dangerous animals in Africa.
It's these guys.
Yes, these guys.
You can have to come over the river to get us.
You've noticed the one straight on at 12 o'clock.
Wow, he's big.
He's interesting. You can see he's rubbing his. It's horns, yeah. Yellow build. Is it an oxpecker? That hangs on their back and keeps eating.
Right there? Mm. The yellow build? The black?
No. That one is rubbing their head at the
back. Oh, they check. Bunch of little chicks.
Yeah, so that, yeah.
Very high density of these buffaloes.
Do they pick on the other animals?
No, they're pretty mean.
But so again, they're mean to other animals?
Yeah, it's good that they're vegetarians.
Yeah. Yeah, they're feeding the forest.
But they're vegetarians.
No, but it doesn't matter. They cut you in half, man.
That's right.
No, they're feeding the forest.
That's what they said. They just cut you in half and leave you.
Noticed what standing somewhere and just watching,
mm-hmm.
You see them doing something different. That's the beauty of being alone there. Slowly moving across the water.
Come on.
flamingos.
You're allowed to come.
Remind you all. Let's film. A camera.
We're now in Lake Nakuru National Park, Kenya's bird national park with millions of flamingos that do come here. I think it's a bird spectacle. We've got so many birds here, different species. It's a rhino sanctuary. It's a really beautiful sunny day. We've got the pink and white flamingos coming each year here to eat the blue-green algae. We are having a great time here. We are hoping to see more animals, zebras, buffaloes. We've seen great buffaloes here. I mean, you've got to be to come to Lake Nakuru National Park. This is where you'd find all the flamingos coming together and staying here for weeks, just eating the blue-green algae.
Hello, Donnie.
Hi. I'm staying safe in the truck.
Need a little tan?
Very busy doing nothing.
I always thought that flamingos were pink because they ate shrimp.
Velvet monkey.
Here we are on Halloween. We decided to stop and have some lunch. We should see some baboons soon, hopefully.
Thank you.
Hold on. We got something going on here? Oh yeah, lots of
there's a lot of
flying whatevers.
There's lots.
What do you do there? You just stand on it, I guess, huh?
Yeah, I can live with that.
Hmm.
Boy, do they blend nicely.
And that's a warthog?
Is the here?
A warthog. Close. At 9 o'clock.
Oh yeah.
Then there's an impala. At 10 o'clock.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Warthog, huh?
When the lions, feel like having white bottoms.
Yes,
grunts. The Thompsons have a black, this black stripe mm-hmm. at the other side. The grunts would have something similar to that, but their bottoms would be white. They're fluffy hair behind them, and grunts are a little bigger than Thompsons.
Wow.
They can take days without drinking water, just depending on the dew in the morning.
Wow.
There's a whole herd of water buffalo, I think, over there, right?
Oh my god.
Known for jumping over fences that are 6 meters high.
Oh no.
They are huge and massive.
At midday we have a rhino.
The bull baboons are like on the left side of the tree. Mm-hmm.
You said 3 o'clock, but they were very buried in 3 o'clock.
Oh, there's a whole bunch of baboons out there, about 20.
Oh yeah.
Can they move closer?
Let's see the eland first. There's no way animals are going to take it. There are some conservancies around the park. Again, there's a gate there, so animals can go through.
Oh, where's the fence?
Outside the gate. But the bone is on the park. A baby buffalo.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
wow.
Maureen, I think you might want to have the baby.
Oh,
that's a buffalo.
Oh.
Can someone tell me what kind of rhino this is? Is this a white or a black one?
Black.
Why?
He looks white, but
it's black.
He's trying to avoid the cat's trick question.
Yeah, he's black, he's full of mud.
No, this is a white rhino.
Why?
It has wide lips.
That's
the Dutch word for? This one is about
The rhinos, the horns are compressed here, like grow like our fingernails.
Of our rhinos,
oh, man.
Especially the black rhinos. So these were introduced from South Africa, and they're brought to Lake Nakuru. So Lake Nakuru is a rhino sanctuary, places to grow them so that you can reintroduce them to the wild.
Like the birds like them.
There. Just to mark their territories. I think they are interesting, their way of life. Very, very solitary in nature. This van, can't they just stop? The oxpecker is just taking advantage of the ticks. They have a very, very good sense of smell and hearing. Excellent, but they have a terrible eyesight. A way of telling the age.
Yeah. Sexy
baby. It's a male guy.
Oh.
Still pretty sexy, huh? One sitting down.
No, he's on the right, extreme right. He's on the extreme right, mostly young and very energetic. So you have to fight to keep the women, you have to fight to get a chance to pass on your genes. So in part,
beautiful animals.
What a buck, huh?
I'm not sure if lions like them.
They don't even want to eat them.
Yeah, and even humans, because I think if you roast the meat, you might lose all of it. It's a bit spongy. Spongy.
Oh, spongy.
Because they spend a lot of time at the water point. But they're beautiful animals.
What's it called?
Lilac-breasted roller. That's sometimes how they sleep.
Oh, he does the same thing. They roll in the dirt and stick.
Or maybe they're just showing off.
Is that what he's doing? Is he showing up? That's a boy. All the boys like this. Yeah, like I said, when I saw the birds with that, I saw that's definitely a male. Very long.
Yes.
Look at
it's a family now.
The baby's so cute. Now is the male the one in the back?
Yeah. That's a beautiful sight.
Is there something
the
about
flamingos
their spines
in
the back? What's different or what's
that's
different?
A great picture.
The male. The difference in male female, aren't they? Oh, he's got horns. No, the girl has horns. Has he got more horns?
Both of them usually have horns.
Oh, I see.
They pick on the ticks.
And he's eating the ticks.
This baby could be less than 2 years old.
That's a cute baby. Because they get big so quick, huh?
Yeah, very, very. Even a newly born one would have a huge head, which is very unproportionate. Disproportionate to the body.
Hold on, Dustin. Legs. Oh, you see them?
Children.
Oh.
And you can tell there's a close pattern amongst the families. All of them are different, like our fingerprints. But there's a close correlation in pattern. Like you could easily tell the children here and the female one and the male one. These three on the left have a similar pattern on the back.
Right.
And the one on the right is a little different. But
and
then
that's a baby?
Yes. Very interesting. So family groups also have a bit of correlation in pattern, but they're all different.
Over there. Mm-hmm. Oh, they're all over. Yep. They're laying around. They're just laying around.
Hanging out at the fence.
Mm-hmm. Well, they can get over that fence, can't they? Above them?
Yeah, they do climb over the fence. These are male impalas. I like the pattern. I like the stocking, the socks they wear. Looks nice.
Yeah.
And they usually put on a very beautiful brown coat.
Every time I take a picture, takes a dump.
Like where he's dropped his things, the others on the other.
The
okay, yeah.
Well, there's an expression, don't shit where you eat. You know? Yeah. You don't want to be the same place.
But the baboon, there's one having a great, interesting.
Oh, so cute.
They know how to get attention.
Is that what they're doing that for? Oh, look at the back. See them back there, Ben?
Yeah.
It's a whole
there's
family,
a bunch of
babies
them to the right at 4 o'clock.
They always have a way of catching and getting our attention. They know they are not in the list of big five, but somehow
they can be mean when they jump into vehicles, look for anything to eat.
So the lunch is in the back, is it?
Yeah, the lunch is covered properly. All right, so we can jump out for a few minutes, enjoy the excellent view. The rails may not...
Rats?
No.
Muskrats?
Could be a muskrat, huh? Looks like a muskrat.
Look at them on the tree. But look at them with the keys and try to...
Great picture.
Yeah.
Does that look?
Their trunk is not as long as the shape of their nose, and their DNA structure,
same structure.
As elephants.
Oh.
Same family.
So
same
it is more the future generation.
So seeing that as their prehistoric remains,
they've
been able to dig.
Well, the DNA.
All right. Takes a while.
Maureen, look behind you. Maureen, right here.
Oh, it's a water bottle. That's why we didn't eat up here. There's a perfect example. Now I'm going to take it. Hope it happens.
Yours. Oh, you're going to show me how you drink?
It's a boy. It's a boy. Have you got any background?
Yeah, later.
Can we get something out of here? I don't know. Get a little drip of water?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? You get the paper, that's sweet.
I'm not young. I can do it easy. Can we take this one as well? Stick that on the DVD. Yeah. Alright, one more guy.
I got something to eat.
Say it again.
Want to get a picture?
No, I don't want a picture. Doing everything okay?
Okay. Stay right there.
I'll stay right here. Now, what is that room? It's a dung room. There's guy. He's done.
Here. Check it out, Rob. Jesus pee on the rock and the swale takes it out.
Oh, look at that. Isn't that exciting? Then over here, you got one where you can take a dump in the little spiel there. Very nice. There's Maureen walking towards the baboons.
Yeah, remember, they're not as friendly. Remember, they don't want to. All the little boys show up.
It's nice to see them do that on their own free will.
Right. Look at the triplets.
Yeah, look at the faces.
And is that the mommy or the sister?
Cousin sister.
Look at this.
Now, do they mix with each other or make it, they mate with each other?
Yeah,
or do they? She wants to know. She's ready to show up. What should we do?
Yeah, I just walk away slowly. She's just trying to assert her authority.
Yes, these are my babies.
You know, sometimes when you're just driving, you may just think this bad. Oh. Just standing there, just watching them.
Are they herding the fish?
They're down at the same time.
It's one of those big nests you find in the park. It belongs to a very small bird called the hammercop. The bird is the size of this camera, Rob's camera.
You're kidding, that.
And it makes such a huge nest, actually. If you find your socks missing, your scarf, everything, they're always tucked up in the nest.
That is huge for a bird that size. It looks like. Robert!
Enough to do for you, right? Gosh.
That's beautiful. So much. They are so beautiful.
And they're all wearing white stockings.
Yeah.
It's a big group. Maureen, I want you to notice the stockings. They're all wearing white stockings.
Yeah.
The other, these giraffes are only found in this park.
Is that right?
This
in
kind.
This park?
And reticulated. We may not be able to see reticulated because it's found in northern Kenya. But these are very, very unique and interesting creatures. The tongue of a giraffe is 25 centimeters, can go around your head.
And they like to spit.
Yeah, Robert, didn't it?
These are very difficult animals to move because they usually have a very high blood pressure.
Oh, so you
can't spit. It's
stressing out.
Them to donate a few giraffes to us.
And now one of them has really dark spots, and the other guys are more beige.
Yes, and you'll see that very notably in this time.
This standing.
Tell me when you've taken it down. Sorry, Dad.
Yeah.
I got one of.
Is that how it goes with you, Frank?